Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to move and resize windows on a Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when you work on a Mac, you're working a lot with windows. Windows like this one. This is a Finder window here, but you also have windows when you're working with documents, say in Pages or TextEdit, or in a browser like in Safari. You can move windows around on the screen and resize them as you like. To move a window, what you need to do is click and drag at the top of the window. You can do it anywhere along the top as long as there's no other button in the way. So for instance, I could click here where there's an empty space and drag the window around. You can do it over here on the left side as well. Anywhere on the top, but of course if there's a button there, then that button is what I'm going to trigger when I click. So grab an empty space to move the window around. You can't drag a window past the menu bar there at the top, but you can drag it below or off to the side. But most of the time you just want to keep the whole window in view, even if other windows are covering it. Now you can resize windows really easily by dragging any of the four sides or any of the four corners. For instance, if I wanted this window to be narrower, I would drag the right side and move it to the left. Notice that when I put the cursor over the edge, it changes and shows me an arrow pointing in both directions, indicating what I can do. I can click and drag left or right to resize the window. I could do that with the bottom as well, but notice that now I have up and down arrows indicating that I could drag up or down. I could do it with the top or with the left. When you drag a corner, you're dragging two sides. So the most common thing to do is drag the bottom right-hand corner to resize the window. It will leave the top left-hand corner exactly where it is, but it will allow me to shrink it horizontally and vertically, or expand it horizontally and vertically. But you could drag any other corner as well. You can drag the lower left-hand corner, you could drag the upper right-hand corner, and you could drag the upper left-hand corner. This is essentially all you need to do to be able to position and resize the windows as you like. But there's a whole bunch of extra functionality hidden here if you know how to access it. So first I want to show you how windows react to each other, specifically their edges. Now you may have been told that you need to get third-party apps to have windows kind of click in place, but you don't. You can do a lot of that using just macOS by itself. For instance, if I were to drag the right side of this document's window and move it near the left side of this text edit window, it locks in place. It kind of snaps there. You have to try it out for yourself to kind of feel what it's like, but it's easy to actually get the left side of this window and the right side of this window to match perfectly. And that works when you're moving windows too. So I can move this window, but if I move it over here, it kind of snaps over. You can see as I move it there, it snaps in place. It's easy to line these up. Give this a try on your own to see what it feels like. And that works for the top, bottom, left, and right sides as well. So it's really easy to set up your windows so that they are in specific locations. Like I could make these two windows work like this, and then maybe even add another one down here. Now I've shown how you can drag the sides and the corners, but there are other things you can do as well. For instance, if I were to double click the right side, the window will expand all the way to the edge of the screen. That works with any side. So I can do the top, I can do the bottom, and I can do the left. It also works with corners. So if I double click the bottom right corner, it will snap that corner to the bottom right corner of my screen. Now holding down modifier keys does things as well. If I hold down the Option key and drag the right side, the right and left sides will move together, leaving the center of the window exactly where it is. The same thing with the top and bottom. Option dragging either the top or bottom will leave the center of the window where it is and move both the top and the bottom at the same time. If I shift click and drag, it will hold the center for the entire window while at the same time moving three sides, the side you're moving and the two adjacent, so the top, bottom, and right. In other words, the opposite side is kept in the same position. So I can move this side here and you can see the right side of the window is kept in the same position. If I move the top, the bottom of the window is in the same position. What if I use the Option key with a corner? While keeping things consistent, it will move that corner and the opposite corner at the same time. In other words, all four sides move, but the center of the window stays the same. So Option click any of the four corners and you can see how the center of the window stays there and the entire window shrinks or expands. Now what if I use the Option key while double clicking? So if I were to use the Option key and drag the right side, it drags both the right side and the opposite side. If I Option double click, it will move both left and right sides to the edges of the screen. The same thing will happen with top and bottom. Option and double click the top or bottom moves both the top and bottom to the edges of the screen. So the ultimate is to Option double click a corner. This will move all four sides to the edges of the screen. This is what a lot of people are looking for when they say they want to maximize a window. A lot of times people will instead use this green button here, which instead goes to full screen mode, creating a separate desktop with just this app, hiding the menu bar and all of that. A lot of times people don't want that. They still want the window. They just want the window to fill the maximum amount of space. Even Option clicking on the green button and using Zoom doesn't quite do that. What Zoom does is it will expand the window to be the size it needs to be to fit all the content. Sometimes that's full screen. But other times, like here in the Finder with just these documents in a Finder window, this is the amount of space needed to show everything, so it only expands to this size. If you want the Finder window to actually fill the screen, Option double click any corner to do that. So here are two other tricks I want to show you. One is you can move a window without bringing it to the front. Notice if I want to move this Finder window, if I click on the toolbar here at the top, I can drag, but notice it brought the window to the front, as it should if you click on the window. If you want to actually drag the window without bringing it to the front, hold the Command key down. Then you could drag the window and notice it remains in its position here behind this other window. You can even resize a window with the Command key down. Notice how I can resize this window here without ever bringing it to the front. That's handy to know, especially if you want to keep a window here up front, but maybe you want to shrink this one down and then move it behind that window. Another tip is there's a way to really quickly make both of these windows cover exactly half the screen. Now, I'm not talking about using split view. Split view is just like full screen, but you tile one to one side, click, and now you've got that second window on the other side, and you're in full screen mode but with two apps instead of one. What I'm talking about is holding the Option key down with the cursor over the green button, and you'll see this changes to move window to left side of screen and move window to the right side of the screen. And this will resize the window and move it to the left side. Now, with this window, I can do the same thing, but I will use the Option key and choose Move Window to the right side of the screen. Notice it has to say Move, not Tile. Tile will take it into a separate desktop, but Move will actually just resize the window. So now you can see I've got two windows perfectly sized to fit half the screen each. You could also do the same thing in the Window menu here. Notice there are two Tile Window commands. Hold the Option key down and those change to Move Window commands. So you could do Move Window, select this one, Move Window, and now you've got it like that. Notice that when it's already on the right side of the screen, that menu option is missing. But you can revert to the original window size. So I can move this to the right side of the screen. I can move now it over to the left side of the screen. Those are now on top of each other. So those options are handy to know about. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.